Sa video natin ngayon, sasagutan natin yung problem na to. So, determine the force in members CD, CJ, GJ, and CG daw, and state if the following members are in tension or compression. Now, yung first natin gagawin is, we have to solve the reactions. Now, since I'm going to use the method of sections for these problems, then I will just consider the reaction at E na lang. Kasi pag alam ko na yung reaction at E, I can make this cut kasi merong CD, CJ, saka GJ, included na lahat yan. CD, CJ, saka GJ. So ito na lang yung cut na gagawin ko, then I will just solve EY. Ayan. And then yung EX natin, automatic na yan, magiging 0 kasi walang horizontal force applied sa truss natin. So, this is 0. Then, to get EY, we can sum up moments about point A equal to 0. So, we have EY, then multiply ko yan by 1.5 multiplied by 4, or simply 6. So, negative EY times 6. Bakit negative? Negative kasi yung ikot na makukos ng EY about point A is counterclockwise. And then we have plus 6, this one, then times 1.5. Then plus 12, multiply ko by 1.5 times 2, or 3. And then we also have 9 kilonewtons times 1.5 multiplied by 3, or essentially 4.5. So, plus pa rin kasi clockwise yung ikot niya. Then, 4.5. Then, we have 6 kilonewtons times 6. Or pwede mo rin siya i-join dito sa EY times 6. Kasi same moment arm sila. But, ito na lang para mas intuitive talaga. And then, yung 4, hindi siya kasali kasi it directly hits point A. So, wala siyang rotation na makukos about that point. So, equate ko na lang to 0. And then, let's solve EY. So, we have negative 6x plus 6 times 1.5. Then, plus 12 multiplied by 3 plus 9 times 4.5. And then, plus 36 equals 0. So, solving EY, we have 20.25. Ayan. And then, this is kilonewtons. Sulat na lang din natin. Now, if I am to make this cut, then the internal forces of GJ, CJ, and CD will be revealed. So, assume na lang natin lahat na in tension sila. Yan. Mas maganda kasi yan, kasi if the answer comes out to be negative, then alam mo na, it's already in compression. So, mas maganda pag tension na lang lahat ng assumption natin. So, this is GJ. Ito naman CJ saka CD. And then, since tensile force sa kabilang side naman, tensile pa rin, away from the joint. So, itong CD, away from the joint, yung CJ, saka yung GJ. But sa left side of the section, then it would be away from this joint, then away from this joint naman, ito. Then ito rin. Yan, ito yung tensile forces na maglalabasan if you will cut the section. I mean, if you will cut the truss. So, you can consider the section to the left or to the right, depending on which is convenient, which is more convenient. Now, alam naman natin na masyadong maraming forces dito. So, mas maganda kapag ito lang yung i-consider natin. So, right side ng section. Para hindi na din natin magamit yung reaction at A kasi hindi kasi natin siya sinolve. So, ito na lang. And then, let's first solve si D. Yan. And then, yung gagamitin ko na method for all of these would be the method of moments na lang. Wala akong gagamiting equilibrium equations. I mean, yung summation of forces vertical saka horizontal para sa tatlong forces na to. For the sake na ma-explore nyo yung method of sections. So, to solve CD, we can sum up moments about... Now, ito yung problema. Usually, yung students nahihirapan sa pag-identify kung saan ka mag-moment. Now, ito yung tip ko. Usually, kapag ito yung cut mo, parang essentially straight line lang yun. Pwede rin siya i-straight line lang. Notice na meron tayong tatlong members na maglalabasan. Tatlong internal forces. Now, if you want to solve CD, this member, then try to look at the two remaining forces. Now, we have GJ. We also have CJ. Notice na merong common letter. Diba, meron yung CJ, merong J. Yung GJ, meron ding J. Now, yung ibig sabihin yan, yung lines of action ng GJ saka CJ, tatama sa J. Diba, ito man yung originating point nila. So, meaning, we can take moments about J to get CD. Yan. Yung pag-identify sa common letter, yan lang yung parang shortcut. Pero essentially, yung line of action talaga yung kailangan natin tingnan. So, mag-moment ako sa J, then equate ko to 0. Now, we will consider the right side of the section. Ayan. And then, we have yung GJ saka CJ, hindi na sila masasali kasi tatama sila sa point J. Yung 9KN din, hindi na yan kasali. So, what will cause a moment about point J would be CD. Now, kapag ito yung hahawakan mo and then you will apply this force to the right, the rotation is clockwise. Therefore, we have CD positive then multiplied by 1 meter. Yan yung moment arm niya patungo sa J. And then we have 6 kilonewtons. This will cause a clockwise rotation about point J. So, we would have plus 6 then multiplied by 1.5 perpendicular distance. And then we also have EY, which will cause a counterclockwise rotation about point G. So minus 20.25, then multiply ko yan by the moment arm, which is still 1.5 pa rin. Ayan. So we can now set this to 0, and then automatic na siyang masosolve. So, CD equals itong kanan na lang. So, X then plus 6, huwag mo na isali yung 1 times 1.5 and then minus 20.25 multiplied by 1.5. Set to 0. Solving CD, we have 21.375. So, this is in kilonewtons. And then, is it tension or compression? This is tension kasi positive yung lumabas na value. Yung inassume kasi natin na direction is tensile lahat. So, kapag positive, it means na tama yung assumption na tensile. So, this is in tension. Now, in the case na negative yung lalabas, then alam na natin automatically that the member is in compression. So, ito na yung sagot natin. Ayan. Now, let's try to solve CJ naman. Ayan, CJ. Now, if we want to solve CJ, we can look at the remaining forces. Now, we have GJ. We also have CD. Notice na walang common letter dyan. So, saan ba mag-moment? Diba, ito yung medyo challenging. Now, try to look at the lines of action of GJ and CD. Notice that we can extend the lines of action. Diba, yung GJ, line of action niya, pag in-extend natin, tatama sa point E. And then, yung line of action ng CD, extend natin, tatama rin sa point E. Meaning, point of intersection yung point E sa forces ng GJ saka CD. Ayan. Point of intersection yan. Therefore, we can take moments pala about point E para mas maging madali yung solution natin. So, summing up moments about point E, hindi nakasali yung GJ saka CD. So, medyo madali na lang. So, summation of moments about E equal to 0. So, we would have yung 6kN and 20.25, hindi na yan kasali kasi tatama sila sa point E. Their lines of action hit point E. So, ito na lang yung kasali. Then, this will cause a counterclockwise rotation about E. So, minus 9, then the moment arm is 1.5 meters times 1.5. Now, itong CJ, notice na if you will consider the right side of the section, di ba, right side man yung kinonsider natin, then CJ will have two components. Di ba, this will have a component along X. Let's say this is CJX, and it will also have a component along Y, which is CJY. Ayan. Now, we have two components, so medyo marami yung forces natin. So, later, I will show you na you can apply the principle of transmissibility for this type of problem. Now, let me just remove this one and also this one. Yan. And then, let's try to apply the principle of transmissibility later. Let's try to solve the problem using the components lang muna. Now, let's first identify kung ano yung slope nito. So, CD is inclined. And then, this is 1. While the horizontal distance is 1.5. So, for CJ, parang 1 yung vertical component, 1.5 yung horizontal. Then, let's try to solve the, anong tawag dito? Let's try to solve the hypotenuse. So, we have square root of 1 squared plus 1.5 squared. Now, you may also use the angle if mas prefer mo siya. But, for the sake of discussion, ito na lang yung gagawin ko. So, this would be square root of 13 divided by 2. Now, naka-fraction yung, ano natin, yung hypotenuse. So, mas maganda yata kapag yung angle na lang. Pero, depende na yan sa'yo. Pwede ko namang ipakita yung dalawang methods. Paano ba to? Ano na lang. If we will apply the principle of transmissibility, let's just use the angle. But for this configuration, let's use the components of the triangle. Para holistic talaga yung discussion natin. So again, taking moments about point E, we have CJX. This will cause a counterclockwise rotation about point E. And then CJX is the force in CJ, bale, minus CJ, then times the vertical, the horizontal component, kasi CJX, which is 1.5 yung horizontal distance, then divided by the hypotenuse. Square root of 13 divided by 2. Ayan. And then, we have the downward component, which will cause a counterclockwise rotation, so minus pa rin. Minus CJ times, by the way, merong kulang pala dito. Meron pa kasi itong moment arm. Kinomponent pa natin siya, then we have a moment arm of 1 meter for CJX. Yan, 1 meter. And then minus CJ, then I have to multiply this by the vertical component, 1, divided by the hypotenuse. Square root of 13 divided by 2. Then our moment arm is vertical, this is the perpendicular distance, 1.5. So, times 1.5. Set mo yan to 0. By the way, our components are to the left and downward kasi this is acting downward and to the left. Yan, parang southwest. So, solve natin yung CJ ulit. Negative 9 times 1.5. Then, minus CJ times 1.5 divided by square root of 13 divided by 2. Times 1, or pwede mo nang hindi yan isulat. Then, times CJ times 1 over square root of 13 divided by 2. Tapos, multiplied by 1.5. Set to 0, we can now solve CJ. So, CJ is negative 8.11. This is kilonewtons and then compression. Bakit compression? Negative kasi yung lumabas. So, mali yung assumption natin. So, box ko na lang to. Ayan. Now, how can we simplify our solution further by using the principle of transmissibility? Now, itong member CJ, we can actually move it sa point na to, sa point C. So, copy natin to, and then transmit natin siya dito sa C, point C. Ayan. Now, nakopy to. Wait lang. Ayan. Now, transmitting CJ sa point C, notice that the horizontal and vertical components, tanggalin ko na lang to. So, this is 1. Yung horizontal component ng CJ is andito na. So, this is CJX, and then the vertical component is acting downward. So, this would be CJY. Now, notice na if you will apply the principle of transmissibility, then CJX will hit point E, yung line of action niya. So, this will be eliminated in our equation. So, what will only cause a moment is only CJY na lang. So, still the same, moment about point E tayo, but hindi nakasali yung CJX. So, our solution would be CJY, which is CJ times the vertical distance, 1, divided by the hypotenuse, square root of 13 divided by 2, and then our moment arm is, na-transmit na siya dito, so, going to point E, we have a distance of 3 meters. So, times 3. And then, yung rotation niya is counterclockwise. So, we have to use a negative sign. And then, we have 9 kilonewtons, which will cause a counterclockwise rotation pa rin. So, minus 9 times 1.5. And then, itong dalawa, wala pa rin silang moments na makukause about point E. So, equate this now to 0. Now, don't be tricked kasi usually kapag in-apply yung principle of transmissibility, you might be tempted to use the 12 kilonewton load. I-include mo siya sa ano mo, moments. But take note na we are considering this section, the right portion of the cut. So, yung 12 kN essentially hindi yan kasali. Yung CJ lang, tinransmit lang natin siya. Kaya kasali, kaya andito na siya sa gitna. So we have negative CJ then times 1 divided by square root of 13 divided by 2 then multiplied by 3 minus 9 times 1.5. Set to 0, we have still the same answer. Diba? So CJ is still negative 8.11 kilonewtons and then compression. But try to see the difference. Kanina, we had 3 expressions sa equation natin. Yan. So, masyadong mahaba. But dito sa principle of transmissibility, we only had 2 terms. This one and this one. So, you can further reduce your solutions by applying the principle of transmissibility talaga. So, next, we can solve GJ naman. this member. So ito yan. Member GJ. Now try to look at the remaining members. We have CJ, we also have CD. So ano yung common letter nila? Diba, the common letter is C. Meaning, pwede tayong mag-moment sa point C para makuha natin yung GJ. So yan yung method para mas madali mo siyang ma-determine kung saan ka mag-moment. Now, itong GJ, we can apply the principle of transmissibility and then imu-move natin siya sa point na to. Now, this will simplify our solution since the vertical component of GJ would be hitting point C. So, hindi na siya masasali. So, essentially, we have GJY and we also have GJX acting to the left. So, yung GJY, tatama na yung line of action niya sa point C. So, hindi na siya kasali. So, ito na lang, GJX. Now, what we need is the slope. So, the slope is, hindi ko pala nagamit yung angle kanina. So, dito na lang, sa member GJ na, sa member GJ ko na lang gagamitin yung angle theta. So, let me label the angle with respect to the horizontal as theta. Ayan. So, we are to consider this whole triangle talaga. Now, for this triangle, draw na lang natin ulit. Ayan, this is theta. The horizontal distance is 1.5 plus 1.5 or 3. And then the vertical distance is equal to 2. Ayan. So, to get the angle theta, we can use the tangent function. So, tangent of theta equals opposite divided by adjacent. So, 2 divided by 3. Taking the arctangent of both sides, we have arctangent of 2/3. This is 33.69. Now, store ko na lang yan sa letter A para magamit talaga natin yung exact value. So, theta equals 33.69. Then, nasa letter A yan. So, for GJ, again, we have to take moments about point C. Saan ba? Dito na lang. Summation of moments about C equal to 0. So, itong GJY, hindi na yan kasali. Only GJX will cause moments or rotation. So, GJX is GJ times cosine. Cosine of theta. So, nakastore yan sa letter A. And then, this will cause a counterclockwise rotation about point C. So, minus. And then, we have 9 kilonewtons times 1.5 clockwise rotation. Then, 6 kilonewtons clockwise pa rin yung ikot niya. And then, the moment arm is 3 meters total. And then, meron tayong 20.25 which will cause a counterclockwise rotation pag ito yung hawakan natin. So, minus 20.25 multiplied by 3 pa rin. Dalawang 1.5. So, set this to 0. Makukuha mo na yung GJ. Now, you can try the other way around by putting GJ sa joint J. And then, the same lang yung sagot. But this is the most efficient one. So, solving GJ. Wait lang ha. Nakulangan pala ng moment arm yung GJ cos A. Yung component pa yan. So, we have to multiply this by 2. Bakit 2? Ito yung GJX, perpendicular distance is 2 meters. Ayan. So, negative X cosine A. Then, times 2, plus 9 times 1.5, then plus 6 times 3, minus 20.25 multiplied by 3. So solving GJ, we have negative 17.57 or negative 17.58 na lang. So this is KN tapos compression. Ayan. So again, compression since negative yung lumabas. Now what we are left with is CG na lang. What is the force in CG? Now CG is this vertical member. CG. Ayan. Remove ko na lang to. So to get this force, we can apply the method of sections or pwede rin na method of joints na lang. So kapag method of sections yung gusto mo, then your cut will be like this. Yan. And then mag-moment ka sa point A kasi tatama to sa point A saka ito rin. And then since meron ka ng CJ kanina, then you can just use this one para ma-solve mo yung CG. But medyo mahaba siya. What's better actually is to apply the method of joints. So applying the method of joints, dito tayo sa joint G. Ito yung i-consider natin. Now, notice na symmetrical yung truss natin. So, the slope of this triangle, ayan, is equal to this one. So, the same pa rin kanina. And diba, na-solve natin yung theta kanina, which is 33.69. Now, we can use this concept na same yung slope nila to simplify our solutions. So, ito yung mangyayari. Let's consider joint G. So, for joint G, we have three connected members. CG, GH, and GJ. So, this is joint G. Don't forget to include the external load, which is 12 kilonewtons. And then, we have GH. Always assume na tension siya. So, GH... Then this is GJ. And then we have a vertical member, which is CG. So again, same slope to. Yan, saka ito. The same yung slope nila. So it would mean na if we are to sum up forces along X, then GJX must be equal to GHX. Kasi diba, yung 12 kilonewtons, purely vertical force yan. Yung CJ rin, purely vertical force. So, the horizontal components of GJ and GH must counteract each other. So, ito yung gagamitin natin na concept para mas maging madali yung solution natin. So, therefore pala, if equal yung dalawa, therefore, GJ must also be equal to GH. Diba? I hope you agree. So, kapag equal sila, then, nasolve naman natin kanina yung GJ, which is, ano nga yun? Ito, negative 17.58. So, gagamitin natin yung value na yan. Bale, GJ equals this one. Now, we know na GJ is in compression. But wag mo nang palitan yung arrows, just use the negative sign para mas madali. So, we can now sum up forces along Y equal to 0. So, GJ is negative 17.58, saka ito rin, negative 17.58. And so, we can now sum up forces vertical. So, minus 12, since this is acting downward, then minus CJ, then minus dalawang 17.58. So, multiply mo na lang by 2 kasi same forces lang naman tapos symmetrical. So, 2 times 17.58 and then multiply natin by the vertical distance over the hypotenuse or pwede rin na gamitin lang natin yung angle kanina which is 33.69. So, multiply mo lang to by sine of theta. Now, theta is nakastore sa A. So, gagawin ko na lang letter A. Then, equate to 0. So, we have negative 12 minus CG, and then minus 2 times 17.58, tapos sine, wait lang, negative 12 minus CJ, then naka-downward yung components ng GJ saka GH, but take note that we have to use a negative sign. Now nakalimutan ko yan, so paki-change na lang, negative din dapat to. So negative 2 times negative 17.58, this will essentially become positive. Kasi kapag compression yung GJ, then it will actually act toward the joint. So upward dapat yung component niya. So para to avoid changing the orientation of the arrows, palitan mo na lang yung value dito. Gamitin mo na lang yung negative value. So we have negative here. Then sine A. Tapos equate to 0. So solving CJ, we have 7.5. This is kilonewtons, tapos positive yung lumabas, so this is intention pala. So ito na yung mga sagot natin.